Okay, doing this again. Yes, so where was I? Yes, yeah, I'm generally not good at games, but this is a walking simulator, I think, so there's no way I'm gonna be bad at this. Delete, let's redo this. New game. Yes, I am going. You see, Julia. What's your. You are drunk. Should I play like a drunk character? I don't know how to. Okay. Alright, so that's my hands and my feet. It's a very weird way to shuffle. Oh, you know what? Let me change the sensitivity. Maybe let's try 35. Yeah, alright. I guess it's better. So that's where I came from. And this is where I shall go. Wait, my bag. It's already, I think. Okay, cool. Ooh. 10,000 miles away.
Two Forks Tower.
Oh, nice. Okay, so,
hello, whoever this is.
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I, like, sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
Oh, okay. Ooh, I gotta choose real quick.
Okay, you're probably out here because nobody back home can stand you. Which, after this brief introduction, is not a big shock.
Ouch. I'll chalk that up to you being tired and grumpy.
Well, I'd better get some sleep then.
One sec. Now it's my turn.
Okay, good night. Bye.
Let's see. I don't know anything about you, but 9 times out of 10, folks out here simply got dumped.
Huh, is that it?
Close?
Good night.
Good night. Welcome to the job.
Well done.
Good morning, Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
So I can't do anything except pick up the radio.
Hey, sorry, guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, what, 14 hours of sleep? Whew.
Yeah, Jesus, I guess it's what, 6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it, that hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
What's west? What's west?
Are those fucking fireworks?
That's west, okay. Wait.
I need you to confirm. Do you see them?
Yeah, whoa. Yeah.
That's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set him straight.
Okay, wait. I gotta change something. Right. Back. Am I back? Wait. Yeah, now I'm back. Okay.
Do you think you can handle that?
Do I write him a ticket?
Easy there, Dirty Harry.
Well?
Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Supply box? What's supply box?
Smart.
Shut up.
Okay. Alright. Is there a supply box here? Toolbox. I guess it's downstairs. No? Yeah. Open. Find rope in NFS cache box 306. That is okay. So west. Okay, cool. So it's this trail. Cool. Yes, definitely going in the right direction. I am good at navigation. Hop over. Just wanna verify. Yes, definitely still going in the right direction. Right? Yes, that must be it. 306. Oh, yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4.
I found a note to a guy named Ron from some guy Dave.
That's probably Dave Gaskell. He's completely nuts.
Is that right?
Harmless, but yeah. One of those, you know, fall off the grid and eat ants for a week type? Totally fucking cuckoo. Which is kind of what the job attracts.
Granola bar.
Hey, there's a snack in here. Probably gonna eat it.
You definitely do not want to do that. Whatever's in there has been in there for years. That's how you get food poisoning.
Yes, eat it.
I tracked down that rope. It was right where you said.
Great. So you should be set to get down to the lake.
Then let's take it. Get down to the lake. Right, the lake. Lake trail, alright. So, straight. Am I right? No, I'm going in the wrong direction. It's west. Let's go back to the trail. Yeah. There we go. Right? Yes. But it seems like Oh, jogging. Hold R or tap R? Oh wait, let me see. There you go. Shale slide. Alright. Attach rope to hook.
This shale slide is steep. How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos.
Hey.
What about shitty boss is gonna get me killed hill?
Oh, is that Absorca Indian? Maybe Creek?
That's actually English for not in my job description.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but let me
How do you expect me to get down this?
Well, did you get that rope?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, just lash it to something nearby and take it slow.
Lash it to something. Yeah, God, am I Those controls. 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 I'm pretty sure I have my rope. Where is the rope?
Hey, I'm going the right way if I'm at the shale side, right? Toward the fireworks?
You're not lost. Those fireworks are going off to the west of you. It's down the slide and across the meadow, okay?
Oh, Jesus Christ, okay. Rappel!
No.
Oh no. Am I still alive?
Hey.
What the hell's wrong with you?
My shitty boss almost got me killed.
First, your boss is a delight. Secondly, Jesus. What exactly happened?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No, I think I'll make it.
Well, be careful for Christ's sake.
Hey, there's a tie-off point off here just a little way from the shale slide.
Well, you ready to get back on that horse, huh?
Well, I can't go any further is what I'm saying.
That heads south down to the creek, but you should be able to get to the lake just by continuing west. Without any, you know, mountaineering.
All right.
It's a long summer. You can explore later.
There's a big rock outcropping down here near the lake. It's really something.
Yeah, makes for good camping. There used to be a group of guys who would boulder out there a couple times a year.
What happened to them?
Dunno. Just stopped coming out.
Jonesy Lake. Right. Wait, was there something I wanted to report? Never mind. Beer can.
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans. They threw them all over hell.
The idiots down at the lake?
Yeah, them. I just found where they're hanging out.
Let's be good. I'm assuming I'm a park ranger, so let's be a good park ranger and clean stuff up.
What do you know? People with shitty manners drink shitty beer.
What, you don't like a cold musqualite on a hot day?
No, I do. But then again, I didn't say my manners were any good. Better than these fucking litter bugs, though, that's for sure.
Done. Alright. Ooh. Backpacks.
They left their packs tied up here.
Don't fuck with them. The last thing we need is some hikers filing a report about harassment.
Oh, look, they decided to have a campfire, too.
You know, they color-coded the fire danger signs in case people were illiterate. But I guess that doesn't take into account just plain stupid, does it?
Nope. No, it does not.
They left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
Yeah. Stomp out. Mm-hmm.
Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
Well, confiscate them.
After I clean up the beer cans. Confiscate.
Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people. What if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
I found a bra.
Nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
There are, panties.
There are what?
I don't want to say that word again.
Why, because you're 12?
There's,
Yes?
There are two naked ladies out here.
Can you handle that?
Come on, I like naked ladies same as anyone, but there's, you know...
Two? I know this will be tough for you, but try to pick your tongue up off the ground and do your job.
Okay. I found them in the lake.
Skinny dipping?
Yeah.
Oh boy, enjoy dealing with that.
Fucking cool it with the fireworks. I know you guys are setting up bottle rockets out here, okay?
How? Because you're hiding in the bushes, spying on us.
Give him a break, Lily. He probably hasn't seen boobs in 20 years.
He's probably still a virgin.
Took all of your stuff. Fireworks, whiskey, you name it.
What? You dick!
Also, setting off fireworks out here isn't just stupid, it's illegal.
All right.
Hey, that go okay?
It's done.
Well, that's ominous.
Hopefully there won't be any more trouble.
Good. Thanks for going down there.
Well, yeah, of course.
Underwear is still strewn all over down here.
Well, it is a particularly warm evening. Not sure I blame them.
So they just left their stuff down here, but it would be a bad idea for me to toss it all in the lake, right?
Yes, I don't think that'd be wise. If you could refrain from criminal destruction of personal property while on this job, that'd be great, okay?
Well, I put out their fire.
Man. I would have named that forest fire something good, too.
Hey, I can always restart it.
No. I think your first instinct was the right one.
Hey, I'm back near that big rock outcropping, but not sure how to get back.
I'd head west, back towards the lake, and then turn north towards the canyon.
North towards the canyon. Right. Oh. Okay. Oh, I can't sprint or anything.
Pears, pears, pears! Yes!
Is this some sort of code I missed? Are we evacuating or something?
No.
Then what then?
I'm doing a crossword and I figured out the theme. It's homonyms. Pears, pears, pears. The clue was couples peeling fruit. Anyway, hope you're having a good afternoon.
Thanks.
I think I'm supposed to cross that thing. Wait, but then I'm back here, right? Am I not? Yeah, I am. Okay. MS... I'm gonna assume I'm gonna supposed to go through the canyon. Okay. So, let's go through the canyon.
Tower down here near the lake?
Yeah, that's your tower.
So I should go this way.
Well, you're not climbing back up that slide.
That's true. Yeah, canyon.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of a thing to a minimum. Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad, right? Because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home, and try not to get hit by lightning.
Yeah, I'm not sure I got a lot of choice in getting struck down.
Especially not with your electric personality.
Ugh.
I see my joke did not spark your sense of humor.
Ugh!
What, you're not enjoying our current conversation?
Oh my god, lady!
The arc of our budding friendship.
How exactly are you in charge?
Oh, Henry, that's a good one!
Satisfied?
Yes!
Let's open this one, why not? Copy information.
I found a flashlight.
There's one in there? Great. Well, the sun's gonna go down soon, so if the batteries still work, you're in luck.
Ah!
Yeah.
There's a horn or an antler or whatever.
Well, antlers are made of bone, and horns are made of the same stuff as your fingernails.
I guess this is a bone.
Antler. A ranger must have found it this spring.
Cool. Oops. Yeah. Alright. Can we close this? Yes.
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon?
Thunder Canyon?
Hey, I didn't name it. But in the cave? I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous. So I say, fuck it. You're a grown man, you can go where you want.
Great. Used to go caving with someone back in Colorado. She loved it. Might be great to explore it sometime this summer.
Well, that could be fun. Obviously, be very careful.
It doesn't seem that dangerous. Whoa, whoa! Ah, no!
Henry!
Seriously, it's completely fine in here.
God damn it.
Right, so... Look out. Let's see... I'm supposed to go east. East. So, in the cave. Sure, why not?
Hello? This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
Makes sense.
Although, Debbie says she lost them like 3 years ago, so maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
Ah, damn.
Yeah, but maybe you can find another one to get your caving kicks in.
Oh, this one's so close to home and convenient, though.
Aw, sorry, Hank.
There's some guy out here.
Some guy? Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Henry, there's something something someone should have told you about this area.
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. And people come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
Look, bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun.
Well, that trail isn't closed anymore.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I took care of the blocked path. It was backbreaking, but, you know, anything for the service.
Well, thank you.
Anytime. Just the outhouse, then, in terms of going to the bathroom?
You're a man, Henry. You can go wherever you want. Well, number one, at least. And, full disclosure, I pee wherever I want as well.
So this generator is all the power I've got out here?
Yep. It doesn't go through much gas, and, well, you don't have much in the way of electronics, so...
What about my hairdryer?
Oh, I'm sorry. You might just have to make peace with Frizzy Locks.
I could never. I don't think there's any fictional character I hate more than Forrest Burns.
Henry, as an employee of the Forest Service, that is treason.
Yeah, well, he really freaked me out as a kid.
He inspired me to spend the bulk of my 30s keeping the wilderness safe.
A shrink would have a field day with you.
Thanks, Mom.
What kind of name is Forrest Burns, anyway?
Forrest Burns, I get it.
A glorious pun.
I went to junior high with a guy named Royal Butts.
Royal?
Butts.
I didn't think anyone had been named Royal since the 1850s.
Well, Royal's mom, Flo, was a bit of a trendsetter.
Flo Butts? Oh man, that's even worse.
Flo, yeah, well, it's still better than Forrest Burns. I feel like I'm going to be murdered when I'm in the outhouse.
Feeling a little exposed, are we?
Hey, no man in the history of the world has felt tough with his pants around his ankles.
Well, be strong. You can always call if you're having trouble.
Sure, I'll do that.
Oh, okay. The lookout is right there in front of me. What am I doing?
What can I do for you?
Well, my typewriter is on the ground, outside of my tower.
You write?
Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell?
You should get inside.
Fuck me. In.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
My fucking sheets are gone.
They stole your sheets? That's just mean.
Yeah, it sucks. The place is trashed.
Okay, I put in a call.
Okay, thanks.
Do you have any idea who would have done this?
I don't know. Who's out here?
I mean, I don't know either. I've never had a lookout be a target for violence.
Great.
I can't believe someone would do this. I mean, I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about who knows what out there. Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, you can protect yourself, huh?
I just don't worry about it.
Perfect. Keep that attitude up, and you'll have an excellent summer.
Day two.
Wake up!
Oh.
Hey, wake up!
Right, sorry, I pick up radio.
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either. I don't really know why that would be the case.
Can I go fix it?
Well, you probably can't, but what you can do is hike out to where the wire runs through your area and report back if it's down. Then I can track down a ranger to get someone on it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So, you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, all right.
Hey, there's a map in my tower that I'm pretty sure is not USGS regulation, unless I've unknowingly been assigned to work in two orcs and the lake to the east is made of acid.
That sounds erroneous.
Looks like the previous resident was into fantasy.
Hey. Right, let's put you somewhere else. Fine. But come on. Okay. Yeah. Alright, throw it in there. Dang it! And in there. And further in there. Okay, sure. I'll just put you here. Nothing to be done here. Right? Oh, another one. Okay. Before I carry on, I'll be right back. Alright. Survey communications line north up the canyon. Okay. Oof.
It's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold and colder though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
I don't know. Just used to spend a lot of time with our dog, Mayhem.
Mayhem? What kind of name is that?
He was a German Shepherd, big as a truck.
So why not call him Chevy?
Well, we walked out of the shelter and there was some graffiti on a trash can and it said Gecko Mayhem, and he walked over and peed all over it, and there you go.
That's a really cute story.
It is what it is.
Hey, can you hold on a sec?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea.
Hey, your button is still down.
I'm absolutely sure. Would you?
Delilah, I can hear you.
All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard.
I said I could...
Hey, sorry about that.
Are you talking about
me? Anyway, I thought about it, and that story is cute, and, sorry, but you said we? You owned him with someone?
Who was that?
Who was who?
I don't think he has any idea. What was that? Were you talking about me?
What?
You left your button pressed or something.
Henry, that call was work. I was just talking to... Actually, it's not really your business. Why are you freaking out?
I'm not freaking out.
Good. I'm gonna go quiet for a little bit. Call me if it's important.
Okay. Interesting. North. Okay.
I found an old notepad of, I guess, songs. Someone was writing a song called Old Shoshone.
Old Shoshone, where the sky is blue and the teens are nude.
it's just like that, except about 10 times more depressing. Hey, I found a structure that might have been an outhouse once, I think.
Whoa, you don't need my permission to go to the bathroom, but, you know, use abandoned shitters at your own peril.
I mean, I'm in the right area?
I do believe. The comms wire runs for quite a ways. Follow it all the way to the top of Beartooth Point, and if it's not damaged, you can loop around back home.
That must be it. I should be able to find a way down here. We've got one of those caches up there. Let me see if I can find my way around. Here we go.
Whoa, I found a turtle. Maybe it's a tortoise. It's a thing with a shell.
Well, isn't that something?
Hey.
It's actually pretty cute.
Well, Henry, if you decide you want it to keep you company, nobody will mind.
Now, what do I call it? Looks like a,
Oh, this ought to be good.
Turt Reynolds.
Well, now I can't wait to see him.
The mustache is impressive.
You tell him I love Cannonball Run.
Who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, They're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Why do you think they'd be up here?
The hell if I know, but they better have stayed away from our communication stuff.
Well, I hopped down a drop and now I can't climb back up.
Is a pickle.
I can just keep hiking, but I figured I should let you know in case I get myself trapped out here.
How adventurous of you.
I've been doing a lot more climbing out here than I expected.
Well, keep your radio charged. I'd hate to one day find a skeleton with an orange backpack at the bottom of a ravine.
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
Well, follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it. So we really can't reach anyone any other way than these wires?
What else do you suggest? Smoke signals?
Just seems dangerous.
Well, if they don't hear from me for a few days, they'll send someone out, but I'd rather it not come to that.
Okay, the wire's down here.
Okay, good. Any sign of those girls? Did they mess with anything?
I'll look around. Okay, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it the moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Jesus, this is a lot of beer cans. Are they like not? Are they? Don't they have like alcohol poisoning or something? I don't know.
All this climbing and jumping, it's pretty invigorating.
Just wait for the rest of the summer when you'll be sitting on your fat ass 14 hours a day.
Oh wait, I'm heading south. That's south. Great. Or maybe I can do some exploring to the supply drop. Yeah, let's take a look. Lookout supply drop. Yeah, let's start with the supply drop because it's 60 feet away. Empty.
Hey, I'm out at a ravine. What's this thing that spans across it?
That is how you get to my sector.
No kidding. Well, let me hike over.
Well, it's locked up and mainly for emergencies. I've never actually used it. Rangers use it from time to time, but that's it.
Help! Oh, God, it's an emergency!
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got eyes on a tornado! I gotta get out of here!
A tornado in the heart of the Rockies?
Yes!
Holy moly, I need to call this in! Tom, Two Forks sees a tornado! He says he needs an evac into my sector. It's a meteorological impossibility? There haven't been tornadoes in the greater Yellowstone region in 100 million years? You're gonna need him to stay and take a detailed personal account, even if it means giving his life? Okay, I'll tell him. Sorry, Hank. No dice.
Man.
Alright, now we're back here, let's head south. Okay. Aha!
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Oof.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
Ooh.
He was a lookout?
Yeah, kinda, I guess. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
You guys keep in touch, you and the Goodwin kid?
Nah, they took off pretty unceremoniously. Plus, what's a 40-year-old woman gonna do with a teenage pen pal?
Good point.
Anyway, so it goes. Have, fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photodome employee.
I don't know, I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Could be the same person who left that antler.
And maybe they're leaving me an entire creature, piece by piece.
Okay.
Hey, sorry about snapping at you earlier. I thought about it and yeah, I suppose that must have sounded kind of weird when you heard me take that other call. Plus, you're just out here in your own head. Trust me, I know how it is. So, did you break any hearts back in Colorado when you took this job? I myself have chosen to never get attached to anyone who would miss me, but I know I'm a bit of an outlier. I don't mean that the way it sounds. I mean, I care about people, and I like companionship as much as the next person.
I'm actually married.
But you're here.
Everything's fine. Just, you know, we're taking some time apart, getting some fresh air.
A little change.
Yeah.
All right, well, we can just leave it at that.
Thanks. I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards Five Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
the difference. Should I? Let's just go this one. Oh, okay. It's like a shortcut.
I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Excuse me, flapjack?
You know, like a loser, a chotch.
I really don't. But I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot so he can order his crappy martini, you've got just the name to use.
Hey, Flapjack, why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful!
Yeah, let's go down here.
Earlier, when you brought up your wife.
I know you didn't. You were just making conversation. I appreciate it.
So, tell me about her, if you want.
She's a college professor. She's a PhD in biology, evolution, and stuff.
Ooh, evolution. That's a risque subject in these parts. Man, she sounds sexy.
She sure was.
Where does she teach?
Yale.
Yale?
Yep. The Yale.
Shit, Henry.
She flew back and forth. I hated it.
Yeah, I would too.
Yeah. Anyway, that's her. Wow. I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No. I guess the bridge is out here. Still, I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Wow, you're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh yeah, you should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing.
I'm back here. Let's check out what this medicine wheel is. That's west. South.
You had a full-on PhD at home. Part of me thinks that would be insufferable, but then there's another part of me that can't help but indulge the whole hot-for-teacher thing. You know, heavy petting in the book stacks. Furtive glances during lecture. Ooh, office hours roleplay.
We had a lot of fun.
I bet you did. Did she wear glasses the whole nine?
No, she had 20/20 vision. Ha, I don't know. She's Australian, so.
What's that supposed to mean?
I wore shoes and showered, and when I got drunk, I didn't fight half the town.
Mm-hmm. And how often was that?
We had a lot of fun.
Yeah, so I think.
Wow, there's an old, I think it's called a medicine wheel out here?
Yeah, it was made by Crow American Indians hundreds of years ago. There are lots of small ones. Have you ever been to Medicine Wheel Monument over in the Bighorns?
Well, I sure haven't.
Well, it's worth a 3-hour detour on the way home in August.
Neat. I'll keep it in mind.
Tight. All right, then.
Hey, I'm at the medicine wheel, and I can't see the smoke anymore. Where am I headed again?
Towards 5 Mile Creek. It's in the southwest quadrant of your map.
Okay, heading over there now.
Yeah.
I take it you fell prey to the Forest Service's big recruiting effort when it comes to, you know, how the hell you ended up out here.
I saw the job in the paper and figured, you know, what the heck?
What the heck? I've got no ties and no life. Better go spend what's left of it in utter loneliness.
Something like that?
Yeah, thanks to last summer, the bump in Forest Service budget actually allowed for us to advertise for the job. Glad it worked.
What happened last summer that accounted for this, windfall?
Jeez. I mean, the federal government almost let Yellowstone National Park burn to the ground? Ring a bell?
Yellowstone is, like, what, 15 miles away? Why would they do that?
Well, the short story is that for 60 years, we got very good at not letting forest fires happen. And then about 15 years ago, they decided that forest fires in wilderness areas like Yellowstone should be left to burn. So that's what they did. I can't believe you didn't hear about this. There were reports that the entire park was gone. Dan Rather telling the country that President Reagan didn't care on the nightly news? And what the hell's he gonna do? Smoke jump in and snuff one out for the Gipper?
So what should they have done?
I don't even know. By the time the Yellowstone folks realized the little fires weren't gonna burn themselves out, 100,000 acres were gone. It's Yellowstone, you know? People don't want to touch it. But we touch it every single day. But hey, I got a 30 cents an hour raise because we can't have another fiasco. If the goddamn park can burn down again.
Hey, there's a tree out here that's been ripped to hell.
And?
Don't you think that's, you know, like, disconcerting?
Henry, there are 500-pound grizzly bears out here. They sharpen their claws on trees.
We don't have grizzlies in Colorado. People killed them a long time ago.
Well, in the thoroughfare, they hunt people, they kill people, they bury their bodies, and then come back weeks later to eat them because they prefer rotten meat. People just disappear.
Don't you think that's disconcerting?
No, Henry, that's life.
Christ, lady.
All kidding aside, what happened with the professor? If you guys had so much fun, when did it stop?
When she got sick, that's when it stopped.
Oh, my God, I mean, fuck, What happened?
We can talk about it later.
Okay. Okay, Henry. What's her name?
Julia.
That's a nice name.
Well, I'm back at my shitty boss is gonna get me killed hill.
You ready to give it another shot?
Do I seriously have to?
To get down to Five Mile Creek? Yeah, afraid so. It's quite a ways downhill from here.
Okay, this is south, so I guess, yeah, I'm supposed to go down here. Alright then.
How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately. Apparently, with most of them being in this area, the thoroughfare because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
PTSD? That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I don't know. He was in the army. He was off. It's actually the saddest story. He was only discharged because his mother, Brian's grandmother, died. She'd been taking care of him, and Ned was the only next of kin.
Damn. And you got to know Brian a little bit?
Yeah. I talked to him way more than I'd talked to Ned, that's for sure.
How was he at, spotting fires?
Better than you. He actually liked to stay in the tower.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Aha! Let me just double check. I want to clean up as much trash as possible.
Found one of their empties. Guess we're on the right track.
Roger that.
There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around. There's a really nice waterfall down here. Even those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby. Found another.
Roger that.
Let's see. There's a trail up. Which is more up. Here we go.
Campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
No, it seems like it. I swear, they must have drank 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is. I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's another one of those magazines. These girls have a full case of beer left here. A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication. Ah, found my sheets!
So they did break into your tower.
Looks like... Looks like it's been through the shredder, which would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear, or I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it, did not hold back.
You've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking. Maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Well, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
I'm threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
Don't be ridiculous.
It's not ridiculous. I've known you, what, 24 hours? Maybe you're nuts.
God, look, I just came out here to sit in a tower, all right? Not get into some mess with a bunch of co-eds.
It's fine. Gone?
Yeah, they're gone. But you should see this place. It's just... it's weird.
Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know. But they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back. And we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Well...
Hey, Henry?
you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Oh, that's too bad. I read in People he's like 5'0".
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Clothes. I don't really think about it.
Oh, come on.
I got a sweatshirt I like, a jacket I got at the Buckle Barn.
Ooh, I love the Buckle Barn.
Just one of those brown ones, you know?
I do. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
A pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
You're what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
They're steely. Cold, hard stare.
Like a Siberian husky.
Sure.
Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
I could have sworn I saw something. No? Alright, it's fine.
I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and I'll give it to you.
Yeah, that fantasy map from before looks like it was made by Brian Goodwin. The handwriting matches everything in that folder I found.
Maybe it just fell out a while back?
I guess.
Oh, come on. Yeah. Oh. Seriously? Yeah. Manly Thomas. Okay, I don't think there's anything more that I need to do, so...
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Ooh. Skip to day 9.
Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
Not too bad. I could get used to it out here.
That's nice. Look, I called with bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing.
No.
They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not going to be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
Ooh, fast forward again.
Henry. Henry, wake up. Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Whoa.
You're a big dumb idiot.
Oh, baby, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
I don't know. There's some weird stuff going on.
Oh, that's too bad.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
Ooh, whoa.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function. So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and... all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and I'd just be spoiling it. Is there anything else you want to tell me about her?
Yeah, actually. Look, I wasn't honest with you about her.
Well, why not?
Because I messed up. She got really early Alzheimer's and I lost her. She's still alive. She's being taken care of back in Australia, because that's where she's from. She's there.
Oh my God, Henry.
And that's it.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Henry, listen. I'm so sorry you've gone through that. I don't know if you've thought of it this way, but her family is taking care of her, and you need to take care of you.
Thanks.
I'll let you keep hiking.
Found the supplies.
Oh, good. Enjoy.
All right, I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Oh, another full month. Oh, shoot!
Got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
Maybe we call it the Flapjack Fire. Can you sell that as a name?
You really like that, huh?
Yeah, I said I did. It's funny.
Fair enough. Flapjack Fire it is. They'll probably ask me if it was a camp cooking accident or something. So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
I'm sure I would. Sounds pretty great.
It is. Are you looking at the fire?
No, I'm not.
You should. Let me know when you are.
Okay, I'm looking at it again.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Why do you say that?
Because I do. I'm not crazy. I mean, we've had such a good time, right?
Yeah, I think so.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. And I know you're not really available, but I want you to know, well, maybe it'd be nice to get together at the end of the summer. Look, we don't have to plan or even talk about it. I'm just having the thought. I wish I was over there. It'd be nice to be near somebody. We could talk without these radios. We could, you know. It'd be nice to be close to someone. Why don't we both just go watch this fire and try to imagine all the old dead things it's burning away? You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Does problem actually mean murderer? Like how Charles Manson is a problem cult leader?
Oh, come on. You just have to look for tracks. That's it.
Yeah, well, I've seen what they can do to a tree, and trees aren't even food.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
All right. To the lake. Oh, hey, I can... Okay, no, I can't swim or anything. Where's my fishing rod? Can I take it out?
Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the fish and game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
What the... it's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating.
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's...
Oh! Ow!
Are you there? What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head, punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you. This just seems like a misunderstanding or something.
There are people listening to our conversations. The person or these people were hiding in the bushes down here. What the fuck, Dee?
I don't know, Henry. This sounds crazy.
Yeah, and you're not the one who just saw our words on a clipboard out in the middle of nowhere.
Those words were from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with a walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who. What the hell do you think is going on at this place?
Apparently a lot of following you around taking notes, which is unfucking believable, Henry.
Yeah, you're telling me. All right, I'm on my way to Wapiti Meadow. I'll let you know what I find.
Okay. There's got to be a reasonable explanation. Also, I'm gonna call around and see if anyone's had anything weird happen to them or seemed spooked. I don't want to make this bigger than it is yet, you know?
Yeah, understood.
Yeah, okay. Hike safe.
Whoa, Delilah, there's a big chain-link fence between me and the meadow. I don't think I can get past it.
A fence?
Yeah.
How big?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
That's not what this is.
We'll see what you can do to get past it.
Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Look, I'm not gonna be able to get into this place.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
Thank you.
Okay, so I think I'm going to back to the lookout and head south from there. So let's go through the canyon.
Or the Forest Service and let them know this is going on?
Don't you think that would sound, you know, crazy?
Yeah, it is crazy. We have to tell someone.
Tell them what, Henry? Tell them we're being stalked and you were attacked and we don't have any proof?
I don't know. Tell them we're being bothered or something.
Henry, I really like this job, okay? And if I give off even a hint of cuckoo to my bosses, they are never gonna let me come back out here. Do you understand that?
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay, keep your radio close to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I'm not, okay? Let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
Right.
Ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Flapjack fire isn't going anywhere, huh?
No, that's why those guys came out to burn that line. It's at the stage where all we can do is pay attention to it.
They're not gonna try to put it out?
Not yet, apparently.
Alright, cache J307.
Appreciative of that.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Ugh, are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
Some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
Whoa, someone stripped these snowmobiles down to the bone.
Huh.
And that's weird, right?
I mean, I can come up with a bunch of not weird reasons someone would do that out here, but given what's happened, yeah, that's weird.
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah? Where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den, or, you know, anywhere.
I'm thinking I could check out Cache 308. That is to the west. So back. Let's do that first. Thank you. Alright. Alright, back to the scout camp.
Is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
Scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
What type of nerdy hobbies are we talking about with him? Like, a marching band?
Oh, no. Like, comics, model rockets, wizards and wyverns, you know.
Ugh.
Is Wyverns.
Hey, thanks to Brian, I can almost recall by memory the armor classes of most dragons.
The what? No, you can't.
Hey, planar dragons armor class. Let's see.
Okay, no, I believe you. We're good. I guess these little shelters are where they keep the Weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
What? Campfire? Where? What? Oh. I guess I stumped it out. Cool.
These guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Damn.
Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's a memo from their boss. Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would meet someone who'd give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Oh, you know, probably just horned toads.
Maybe Turt was an escapee. And a Wapiti Station clipboard with our conversations on it is just, what, recreation for them?
I'm just messing around. Somebody is obviously up to something. I'm freaking out here.
At least we know there is something real happening behind that fence.
I think that we should consider that maybe this is all just a coincidence, but my gut says that there is something bad going on.
Mine too. Okay. So what's next?
I'm gonna do a scan for supplies and then figure out a way to get back over that ravine and hike towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge help.
For both getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Yeah, I'm out of here.
Nice. Ooh. Just want to double check. Yeah.
Are you there? I had a thought.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, fuck.
There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios.
What about when I heard you talking to someone else?
I just left your line open. That's not what this is. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Whew.
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today. The Flapjack Fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
I didn't sleep a wink last night, and I've been going crazy for the past 6 hours of sunup. How are you so chipper?
Well, it's a new day. What a day, this day we've been given.
Maybe I am actually asleep right now. Maybe I didn't stay up all night knowing that someone is...
I actually slept just great.
Okay.
By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
All right.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
Great! Just wondering. wonderful. Do you see the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Sure. It's the,
No. You don't need to tell me. Just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
Yeah, okay. Maybe I should go for a hike.
Nothing like an afternoon in the Rockies, I tell ya. Radio me the moment you get there.
Right. Alright, keep going south. And west. Ooh.
I'm here at Cottonwood Creek.
You see the cash box there?
It must be around here somewhere.
It is. Find it and open it. I changed the code. It's 5678.
Are you kidding me?
I was in a rush.
Okay, found the cash box.
Great, open it.
Ooh.
I found what you left me.
Good. Call me back with when you have it.
I've got it now.
Good. I spent all day getting you that radio. I hiked to a cash box, lied to a ranger, lied to another ranger, and hopefully you are now holding a clean, untapped radio.
Hopefully.
Holy fuck, Henry. We have to get into that site.
What the fuck is going on? People are listening to us?
I don't know.
Our radios are tapped? Are you fucking serious?
Radios are definitely tapped. That's why I left you the one you just got.
How is this even possible?
I don't know, Henry.
What do you know?
I know that I'm scared.
Are there any other lookouts this is happening to? Someone else in on this? Anyone?
This is just happening to us. Everyone else is fine.
Are you sure?
Yes. I've tried to bring it up to Chimney Rock, Elk's Fork, and Beartooth Lookout, and every one of them got confused. Asked me if I'm okay and if I need to be relieved. Our fucking state coordinator asked if I was just having lady troubles. So no, this isn't happening to anyone else, and I'm done asking.
Who is doing this?
I don't know who could be doing this. Henry, I've been at this job off and on for 13 years. Sometimes here, sometimes over near Jackson, a couple times down in Wind River. And nothing like this has ever happened before.
Am I just making all of this up? I mean, the eavesdropping, the spying, is this... Fuck, are you... Is any of this real?
What? Are you serious?
Maybe I'm just losing my mind.
What?
Like Julia. Maybe it's happening to me, and I'm imagining that I have a boss out here and that we're being spied on.
Henry.
Maybe there was something in the water, or our condo was underneath some power lines, and you, Delilah, you're not real.
Henry, think about her. If what happened to her were happening to you, you wouldn't even be able to realize it.
Okay.
Henry. Sweetie, I am real, and this is happening. I'm as real as the sky is blue. Take a second, and then call me back. I'm on your side. Hey. I just thought of something not great.
What is it?
I filed a report that said that neither of us ever talked to or saw those girls, the ones that went missing a few weeks back.
Oh, shit.
My thoughts exactly.
Our radios were tapped, and now someone probably has a transcript of that entire conversation.
Filed a report that's a blatant lie.
Oh, and those girls are still missing.
Yep.
Fuck, Delilah.
Fuck indeed. We really need to get to the bottom of this.
No, this is definitely the way down. Definitely the way down. Yeah.
I just heard something.
What is it?
I don't know. It was goddamn terrifying, though.
Well, it could be an elk, or it could be someone trying to get you to radio about a loud noise so they know where you are.
Oh, fuck.
How about you don't do that again?
Oh, you know what? Ugh, fuck it, let's just do that. Gonna attach a rope at that place, cause why not? Oh, okay, so it's not here, it's on the other side, I think. That's fine. Let's focus. Alright, so back here, actually I could have made a right. Yeah.
To the gate down. There's nobody around, and it's the quickest way in.
Copy that.
Noise.
I smashed open the gate. Should I try to fix or hide this?
No, screw it.
Okay, then. I got stung by a bee. Yeah.
Did it hurt?
Yes, kind of.
Okay, I'm sorry.
don't see anybody around.
Looking for us?
Yeah, looking for us. Dee, there's some serious comms equipment out here, wireless stuff.
What do you mean?
I'm talking a big 20-foot tall transmission tower. They can probably listen to whoever the hell they want. They're nestled down in this valley, which makes it impossible for you or any lookout to see them.
Let's take a photo. Also,
now they're doing something with the soil out here, too. It's all gritted off.
Who knows what else they're up to?
There's all sorts of contraptions and shit out here.
Like what?
Dishes and stuff on metal legs. There are wires all over the place. I don't know. I'm not really up on high tech. This equipment is not stuff from the hardware store. Definitely some sort of monitoring station. I think I found the thing they use to track us.
Holy shit!
You know, you swear, like, a lot.
Not the time, Hank.
Anyway, it's called a wave receiver. Looks like it picks up anything that emits a signal. It's got basic orienteering capabilities, everything.
Holy shit, Henry.
Yeah, holy shit.
You're gonna take it, right?
Yeah, of course. Okay, this thing is losing its mind, beeping like crazy.
I can hear it. What's it after?
I don't know. I'm gonna go find out. I just wonder where they are. All of their stuff is here.
Figure out what that thing does, and then get the hell out.
This place sleeps three. They've got a row of cots here.
I want to know what that thing finds. Look, you should get out before they come back.
I found their main monitoring desk.
You should get out before they come back.
There's a box here with a dial. It has a needle, like it measures earthquakes.
You mean like a lie detector?
Yeah, I'm not sticking around to get hooked up to it. Here that confirms they're tracking our people's movements. The map's got all sorts of paths and areas marked off on it. There are lines that look like some of the paths I normally take.
Are you positive it's you?
I'm not sure, but I think so. I mean, this stuff looks like it just got lifted out of the space shuttle.
I have to tell you, if I found out this was NASA, I'd be a hell of a lot happier.
I think this thing is responding to something in this pile of crap on the desk.
Dig through it.
Assessments about the two of us. There's stuff in here about Julia.
Like what?
Stuff I didn't tell you. This is...
What does it say about me? You said there was one about me.
And it looks like they've been following me around. What I do when I'm out hiking? Jesus!
Henry, do you hear me?
Do you have a boyfriend, Javier?
What? What the fuck?
Wish you hadn't left that out.
I don't. I didn't. This is insane. I'm so sick of letting these people do this to us. We should just burn the place down. Think about it.
Delilah.
What? Think about it.
I am, and I think it's insane.
They'd be fucked.
Yeah, and how about if that fire comes up the mountain? Or someone were to die in it?
We call it in?
We call it in?
Yeah, maybe.
My God, Delilah, no. No way.
Well, maybe it's not the best idea.
Yeah, it's definitely not the best idea.
Oh, I'm so fucking wound up!
But it's alright. I'm just gonna hike back. We have the wave receiver, and tomorrow we can figure out what to do.
Right. Don't think there's a way I can hit. Through there, no? Yeah, it's fenced off anyway, so yeah.
There's smoke coming from the site. Yeah, I just climbed out of there and the bridge collapsed.
What the hell happened to you? It's definitely not the best idea.
It wasn't me.
What do we do?
We just call it in like any other fire.
And what about who started it? What about them?
The person who started it?
Yeah.
We're talking about people watching us out here who are now burning the forest and everything in it around us. I don't know what to do about that.
Except get the hell out.
Yes, get us the hell out of here.
I will.
Oh, damn.
This receiver just picked something up.
Like a signal? It's going beep beep.
Yeah, what could it be?
I don't know. You gotta find out.
Alright, I'm on my way now.
You know what I just picked up?
No.
A fifth of Major Bueno tequila from the creek.
Are you drunk?
No! I am getting drunk!
Hey, Dee, I don't want to harsh your vibe, but maybe, just maybe, that's a bad idea.
Henry.
What?
You're harshing my vibe. My thinking is I could stay up all night worried I'm going to lose my job because of the side fire, or I could not worry and let the chips fall where they may. It's not like there's any proof we were down there.
My thinking is I'm going to follow this wave receiver.
I like it when you think.
Ay, ay, ay. I'll just leave you alone with whatever these thoughts are. Last thing I need is another big crossword breakthrough.
southeast. It's down there. Let's head to the medicine wheel. And then from here, yeah, you know what, let's just... Maybe I'm going the long way, but... Oh yeah, fire break. Okay, so I guess I gotta go through the... big tree. Wait. Oh, I passed it. It's up here. Well, I just went in one huge ass circle, so it has to be. Yeah. Ooh.
Shit. What? Ah.
Strange bag. Where's the strange bag? How am I supposed to act? Oh, there it is. Oh, it's the cave.
I found some sort of supply bag, light camping gear, some clothes, and basics. It was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
Yeah, I'm fine. But there's also a set of keys here. I don't know why they'd be hidden out here. They say Shoshone National Forest, Cave 452. Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah, it is. Who the hell took them?
And what the hell is in that cave?
Okay, let's just think.
Says the woman with a half a bottle of tequila in her belly.
Maybe they're panicking and we're preparing to beat it. The fire has them spooked and we have new walkie-talkies, so we have the upper hand.
Yeah, well, it's hard to feel like you have the upper hand when you're standing in the dark in the middle of the woods.
Oh. Well, you're back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
I'm not in my tower.
I am looking at a man standing in your living room.
Snap.
It's not you.
It is not me.
Oh my god, go.
I'm going.
Wait, where the hell am I going? Is this the right way? No, it's not the right way. Jesus Christ. Come on. Where's my tower? There it is.
I don't see anyone up here.
She was just there.
It's a tape of us talking down at the site. It sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby. Yeah, and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down, and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
Just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh my god, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
Oh god. No, this is spooky as shit.
So, I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it. Furthermore, I bet you don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
We have to stick together, okay? Keep our story straight. From the first day with those girls to the person breaking in on our conversation, everything. We gotta be honest and consistent.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
I know.
Alright, let's go check out a spooky ass cave. North. Northeast.
would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kinda just wish I hadn't.
Of course I didn't. No way. They're trying to pit us against each other.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
That's not gonna happen, though.
Thanks, Henry.
Alright, cave time!
Jesus, this is a big cave. It's freezing in here. Is anybody down there? Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus!
So you didn't find anything?
No, there's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes. I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous.
I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Really?
Yeah, he built himself a real castle. Bunch of rocks stacked up, he made a wall and a perimeter.
God. Yeah, that's perfect.
You know, maybe he made it because he was afraid of them.
Possibly going through this crap, I get sick to my stomach.
Yeah. Sorry. He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left. He'd hide out here to read comics. The black band, his grief is his enemy's sorrow. Everyone this guy loves gets killed, so he honors them with a black armband, which gives him superpowers.
That's fucking dark.
It's a little weird that he just leaves so much of his stuff out here.
Well, maybe they were in a hurry when they left. Like I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied, and just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and... I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
There's some grade-A dork contraband here.
You found his pocket protector?
I found a data sheet for one Gladius Silva, half-elf, armor 7.
Classic wizards and wyverns.
Yeah, between this and the map I found in my tower, old Brian created quite the fantasy world.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved out there.
Huh, Brian stole his dad's climbing gear, his anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was gonna hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. I mean, he left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah, it sounds like Ned was pushing him, and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put it past old Ned.
There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Yeah, I think that was the one thing Ned did do with him, you know, tinkering on stuff like that.
There's a busted old toy out here, some sort of electronic game.
Yeah? I like Pong.
Everybody likes Pong.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved out there.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
It's some Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much. Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
Yeah, but not smarter than yours truly, right?
Wait, are you seriously feeling threatened by the intelligence of a 12-year-old you've never even met?
I'm just saying, I'm pretty, with it. I'm a pretty bright bulb.
Yeah, Henry, you're a regular Rhodes Scholar.
Nice. I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler. I don't know, really. I mean, we gotta find out. What do you think?
Whatever it is, they don't want you telling anyone about.
They closed the door when they could have just...
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
Are you serious with this shit right now?
A hatchet. God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
Honestly, I just want to know. I want to know what is worth doing everything that's been done to us.
Yeah, me too. And not going to jail would be a nice kicker. Also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them.
Ooh.
Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and landed in jail.
Well then.
Dodged a bullet there.
Yeah, we've got enough unanswered shit to answer for, I'd say.
Oh, cool. I'm back on the trail. Alright. Cave time redux. Redo. Oh, shit.
Oh, God. You fell. You're a good one. God. Poor kid. Your stuff gave out. Hey, D.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
Hey, you, might want to take a seat.
I've been sitting this entire time. I'm almost always sitting. What's wrong?
The only thing in the cave was a body.
A body? God, what a mess.
Delima. It's Brian Goodwin.
You gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. Whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. What do we do now, Dee? I mean, are you okay?
No, I'm not. He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
All right, let's pack up.
You see that plane?
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Well, is this the Flapjack fire or the site fire? Or...
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
About how all this stuff is connected. The surveillance, the Goodwins, Brian's death.
Look, I don't know what to say, okay? It's like the universe cooked up the cruelest thing to have happen. Does it connect to everything else? I don't know. I don't know if I even want to.
Of course you do. There's gotta be a reason.
Was there?
Maybe. Maybe not. I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Well, fuck. For starters, I guess you could find the source of that signal.
Holy crap. Yeah. Oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us. Whoever made the tape.
Okay. Yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
All right, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
I was hoping you'd have a backup plan or something.
Yeah, okay, I'm probably gonna move to Canada. Ontario, maybe.
No, I meant if something happens to me.
Right, if you don't find out who made the tape and I have to hit the road.
Forget it.
Be safe, Henry.
Wait, what do you mean by take the turtle? Like, I mean, there's only one option. It says adopt. I've already adopted it. It's there. Alright, fine. I'll go. I guarantee you, I can't do anything except, like, put it back.
We gotta cheese it, turd.
Okay, I guess you're right. Fine, fine.
Sound worried.
No, it's just...
You, Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
So the lake, I'm guessing.
Someone left a rope for me to climb up. I'm down near the lake.
How do you know it's for you?
There's a tracking collar tied to it. Someone was leading me here. And there's another tape.
Oh shit.
We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Now I gotta go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for croc's sake. I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids. Alright, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. Alright, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us. Just him.
Goodwin. He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. Deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son.
He's got a survival bunker with radios and everything. He made it all up.
You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay. He held on to some of Brian's things. His wizards and wyverns.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he found it riveting.
He... God.
What?
Nothing, just some of Brian's stuff. Brian was a nice-looking kid.
Yeah.
Goodwin was the one who wrote the reports I found at the site. He wrote down everything he did to us. Everything he did every day. He was scared shitless. You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I don't know what you want me to say. We're in the middle of a fire that is at 22,000 acres and growing. Fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well, take a picture if you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
I don't know.
I don't have any photos left.
Let's go.
This boombox looks familiar. He was rigging up stolen batteries to keep his stuff going. Got a radio base station up here. He was listening to us on that. He had quite the view.
All right.
He could see my lookout. doors too.
Guess I'm done here. Okay, evac point, evac point. Alright. Okay, let's keep going west. And at, no, I can't go west. Thunder Canyon. Okay, I have to go south. Yeah, I have to go south. Here we go. Am I even going the right way? No. What am I doing? Not southeast, I have to go east. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna make a left here.
I know I should be relieved. Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. He was a sweet kid. A shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
Lila, I think it was an accident, and I don't think Ned meant to kill him.
We don't know what happened for sure.
Ned wanted his son to be able to climb and do the sorts of things he did himself, but Brian couldn't.
And how'd that turn out, Henry? I'm sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
Dee?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. They're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
I, It's dangerous here, and if anything were to happen, then that would be on me, so.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. You sure that's okay?
I said it was.
All right, I should go.
Have a safe flight.
All right, have a safe hike.
Oh no, oh no. God damn it, am I stuck here? Jesus Christ, I clipped into the goddamn corner and now I can't do anything! No! I can't even spacebar back. Jesus. Alright, this is like 2 minutes ago. That's fine. 2 minutes. I can do 2 minutes.
Stop thinking about it.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
It's dangerous here, and if anything were to happen, then that would be on me, so.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, you sure that's okay?
I said it was.
All right, I should go.
Have a safe flight.
All right, have a safe hike.
Okay. Try number two. Please don't get stuck. Hey, not stuck. Okay, great. Also, let's attach this just for the kick of it. And let me see. I'm supposed to climb up here. Yes. 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 North. 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 Alright, just keep going north. Oh, you know what? I don't know why, but I kinda wanna complete the... Alright, you know what? Just real quick... What I got? Huh. Okay. Never mind then. Thank you. Alright, here's the part where I gotta climb.
Spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there? Delilah? Is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me. I'm back at the staging area near the trailhead. I think I see your truck.
Red? Colorado plates?
Yes. It's a piece of shit.
Well, yeah.
I think there might be a raccoon living in it.
Make sure he's comfy, I guess.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Ugh, shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
Oh, I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
All right, sure. Maybe... Maybe move to Santa Fe. Open a jade emporium with your sister.
I'd be trading cute ski bombs for yoga retreat hippies, but maybe that's not all bad.
Plus the margarita situation?
I mean, yeah.
So what about me?
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
I am. Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Yeah, sure.
Henry, Look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
You're right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could,
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year, we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
Yeah?
Well, you should try to take her advice, too.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
I'll see you when I see you.
Yeah, okay. Sounds good. Bye, Hank.
Well then. Damn. Guess I'm done. 4 hours.